All right, now that we've got the front view and the top view drawn, we're going to move on over to the side view. The side view is mostly projecting the lines that we already have drawn. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll start off, we're going to use the construction layer. I know I kind of go back and forth between just using that, acquiring the point and projecting it up using the polar snapping or the construction lines, which is fine. You do what you feel comfortable with. I'm going to come over here. Of course, it came up on my other screen. We're going to create a new layer, and we're going to call this construction. You know, from that last video, for some reason, no idea why, probably I don't use this layer a lot, and then I think of construction tape. I just think of yellow. So let's just go ahead and set that layer current, and let's just come over here and start projecting construction lines. So remember, construction lines are in the draw. You kind of have to drop it down a little bit to get to it. You can also type X line as well if you prefer that, maybe even XL. All right, so construction line, starting it, but now we need to tell it it's going to be horizontal. We're going to take these lines over from the front view into the side view. The bottom of this, so I'm snapping to the quadrant. We'll come back and worry about the visible lines later, but for now, we're going to do this. We're going to, oops, go back into that. We're going to do a horizontal for the top view as well. So here, 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 here. Like I said, we'll worry about the stuff that's going to be hidden. We'll get the visible lines taken care of first. One more set of construction lines. This time we're going to do V for vertical, and we're going to take it from the intersection. So here, intersecting, where it touches that miter line. That's what we're going to just hit that miter line, drop it down to get that side view. All right, let's go set our visible layer current. And we'll just kind of trace over this with our lines. So we know that this looks like this. It's actually going to be a box that goes all the way over. So that's one way you could handle it. Got another line. It's going to go from here all the way. Really, this one almost goes to the top. Let's do this. We'll talk about that in just a moment. Okay. So if we turn off our construction layer, we can see we've got a nice outline going here. What I want to do is project this line over. So you see how, remember when we did this for the top view, it came up a little bit. We're going to do that for the side view. That line and this line are the exact same lines. So we're going to go ahead and project that up and over. To do that, I'm going to do another construction line. Set that layer current. We'll do a horizontal. Take it right from the endpoint of that line. And then I can either extend or I could just grab this line. When you touch it, you get those blue grips. Let's click on this blue grip and click right here. It just stretched that line out there for me. So now when I turn off my construction layer, it doesn't like me turning off my current layer, but that looks a lot better. There we go. So we've got this line coming all the way up to right to that tangency. Looks good. Now let's come back to our construction layer and let's project across and see what we got. Actually, it's getting kind of cluttered. I'm not going to use construction lines for this, so that's fine. We're going to set our hidden layer current and we'll just use that. The same thing we've been doing. Acquire this point, bring it straight across. That's a hidden line. Look, it almost touches that hidden line, but it doesn't. We're going to acquire that point. This is our O track. We're going to set our center layer current. Take it straight from the center line here. Looks good. All right, now we need to do the same for this circle. But we do need to use the construction line to get that one because we got to hit that miter and then drop it down. So let's go back to construction. Well, let's set the construction layer current. and H for horizontal. We're just going to pick it up from here, here, and here. Now be careful when we're looking at it. So it's not, we're not going to project from this. We're actually projecting. These two are right next to each other. So we got to make sure we're doing it right. Construction line, V for vertical. That was hidden. Center, hidden. All right, let's see if we can do this without getting confused. We're going to draw a line, hidden. Remember, these were right next to each other, but this was the hidden one. This one was the edge of this surface up here. Easy to get confused. There we go. We're going to put a center line right there. Oh my goodness, this looks good. Let's go look at this. Ooh-wee. All right. So we've got everything drawn here. Now what we need to do is that thing where we're going to go in and use the lengthen command, and we're going to lengthen those center lines out. Now, previously, like we did in the bracket, we lengthened out a distance of 0.25, but we're not going to do 0.25 in this one because this is metric. 0.25 is going to be nothing. It's all, I mean, this whole part is 101.6 across. So since we're using millimeters, we're going to do a conversion. You can take that 0.25 and convert it times 25.4. Basically, what we're going to come out with is this extension needs to be 6 millimeters. So we're going to go to modify, lengthen. Remember when we start it, you want to start clicking around, but what we got to do before we click anywhere, type in DE for delta, press enter. We're going to type in our delta length. Remember, delta means change. We're going to type in 6, press enter. And then we'll just click here, click there, click here, click there. Ooh, it did our dash pattern for us. See how it wasn't dashed before? Now the line is long enough to show that dash pattern. Click here, click there. Oh, that is looking so good. All right, now we've almost got it done. The next thing we need to do, we're going to go clean it up a little bit. So we're going to get that broom. We're going to do overkill, which deletes the duplicate objects. Go ahead and highlight everything. It can't hurt. Press enter. When this comes up, just say OK. Basically, we just needed that for this. When we put those two center marks on top of each other, we don't want those lines to be on top of each other there. So that is it. This looks great. We've got our front view, top view, side view. We've got all the lines projected, all the center lines and center features, hidden features. Everything's projected. It looks great. So we are done with this project. We are going to take a break on this one. Whenever we come back in chapter 5 and learn about mechanical dimensioning, we'll come back to this project and we'll add dimensions and notes at that time. So until then, this looks great.